So my name is Teresa, and I did my project on edible insects. So my motive for the paper was kind of, at first I started to research about different proteins and like the kind of proteins that we eat normally in our food. And I kind of like wasn't really interested in it. And while I was researching in it, I saw a lot of talk about the rapid increase in population and kind of the decrease in agricultural land because of these different proteins, like the livestock that we have to grow in order to maintain the population. And I also saw a lot about global warming because of the gases that the livestock has and just the different kind of farming, I guess you could say. And then the reason I chose to do this is because there's not enough research about what we're gonna have in the future. Like if we do have this massive increase in population, like what is it gonna be like in the future? Will we have enough food to sustain the population that we have? There's a lot of people now that even are suffering from world hunger. So with that increase, like what is it gonna be? So then I started to look for alternatives to help our environment, so with global warming and population and food security, considering there are a lot of people suffering from world hunger. And my question at first was, does one's perception of an insect as disgusting change after a rather good tasting bug? And then I added to it and said, would they continue to consume them if they had to? Because we don't know if in the future we will have to use insects, considering the high demand that we are gonna need. So in my research, I decided to blindfold my participants to eat bugs. There were 5 of them. And I did this to consider them, like the future changes that we might have. So kind of all of this is speaking like hypothetical and what could happen. And I fed them because they may like in the future kind of be forced to eat these due to not having enough food sources. And then in my essay, I put the people participating in my study will be blindfolded to remove any bias on the insects based on the looks. And by removing vision, what can be viewed as disgusting can become a start to change in thought about the insect itself. So in many countries, I think it's Europe and Mexico, they're already opening insects into the markets. It's like, it's become something very popular. So in order to have like Westerners become more adaptive to these, you kind of have to introduce them to this new change and then have the method fit. So I recorded the tape, like them tasting the insects, and I did not bring the video, that's on my camera. But I was able to kind of like capture their reaction to see their initial reaction to see whether they actually liked the bug, and with that I could tell if they would consider eating it in the future. And also I was able to become part of the actual study. I did not eat an insect because that's gross and I was not gonna do it, but I was like feeding them, so I got to touch it, I guess. It kind of counts. And so a lot of them were telling me that it was disgusting before they actually ate the insect, but 3 out of the 5 of them actually said it tasted like beef jerky. So I was like, that's kind of gross. Like, 2 of them said that it was disgusting, but they were the 2 that had entered the research kind of already thinking that it was gonna be gross. Like they were the ones that were most heartfelt about it. So I was like, you're already biased, so you don't count. So in my findings, I kind of merged my findings and my counter argument, because I found that the insects can serve as like a temporary fix for curing the people who are malnourished. Like it can be a full dietary change if we do need that population, or if we do need that population increase, but it can serve to help for like a certain amount of time. And then Andrea Stamer stated, insects can sustain both humans and livestock. So what I found interesting about this is like I did researches, and I found that cereal, like the cereal that we produce, 1/3 of it is fed to livestock, instead of like giving it to humans, I guess you can say, that can feed a lot more people. And he was kind of contradicted her, saying, based on eligible termites were developed to combat child malnutrition. So I guess you can say that Stamer and Hughes kind of contradicted, where Stamer is saying that they can sustain both humans and livestock, while Hughes is saying that it's kind of just for a temporary fix, saying that it's like to help with malnutrition. And revision. Okay, so for this, the same thing that I was talking about, the livestock is being fed to is fed with human food, so 1/3 of the cereal produced feeds the livestock. So considering the global food system is beginning to face an impending crisis, action must begin to take place now. Because we are growing at such an unsustainable rate, we should start to consider new ways to feed this livestock, which insects would also benefit with. And then my implications. So I did this because I feel like it would remove personal bias, and it allow them to be more accepting of what is to come. And then a widespread dietary change and could help resolve global warming, considering that these gases are no longer going to be, well, they'll still be gases, but they will be reduced to a place where we can begin to find temporary fixes, like just something small in the meanwhile, while we find something to better it. And then if I could like further this, I would look for different uses for the insects, like what exactly it benefits, because in my research I found mostly like population growth and my agriculture, and then ways it actually benefits the body, because it talked about how it was nutritional, how it contained a lot of proteins. And in one of my research, it talked about how it kind of, it was more nutritional than actual meats that were made and sold. And whether there's a long-term effect to the consumption of these insects, because most of my research didn't really talk about long-term effects. It talked about short-term because people have not been so exposed to it to the point where they've been able to find like a difference in a way that they react to it. And then changes that I would make. So I would look for more information like on what the benefits of they are, and maybe even look into like a different topic that contains more information but still goes along the lines of like edible insects. And then find more things to argue, because my research was kind of limited, but I felt like I was too far in it to kind of change it. So, and then actual real cases and their thoughts on the change. So for my participants, I kind of just asked them, or I had them like take the bugs, but I didn't ask them like how they would feel about this change in dietary needs. I pretty much told them like, this is what's going to happen if we don't start finding alternatives to food sources. So I feel like if I were to ask them for their thoughts rather than simply telling them what is going to happen, that would help.